So how to mobilize the neck and the spine and how to get a little bit of relief while you're working. So the steps are pretty simple. And what we're going to do is, in the last video we covered a little bit of the about the breathing, which helps to just decrease the tension from the shoulders and from the neck. Next part is going to be just how to get a little bit of extra movement actually while still sitting behind the desk or behind the computer. So the first one is going to be just actually being aware of the position we are sitting. So you're going to see it on the side view, that if we are sitting a little bit rounded or even overextended, and if we are using the support, or we are kind of a little bit slouching or kind of trying to be very rigid, very almost like shoulders back. The best position is one which kind of changes constantly. So in the sitting or even standing or walking, there is no right or wrong. Your body is going to pretty much adapt to whatever you do long enough or often enough. So it's a good idea to do different postures, and just when we are, let's say, when we have to spend in that position for quite a long time, just to be able to get in and out of that position, maybe move certain parts which haven't been moved in a while. So the first one is what I love to do is pretty much the cat cow, or like from yoga, and you're going to see it on the side view, and I'm just going to pretty much flex around my back and then just almost like vertebra by vertebra extend. So what I'm trying to do is, you're going to see it from the side, from the pelvis down, I'm trying to bend, almost like fall forward. And next one is I'm trying to kind of extend, so arch a little bit backwards. And just a few of those movements, just trying to develop the awareness. And then maybe for longer sitting, I'm just going to stay kind of somewhere in the middle after a few repetitions. The next one is, what I love is just few rotations. What it is basically from the sitting position, you're pretty much just going to reach and rotate one way, and reach and rotate the other way. The next very good mobilization is you're going to reach and rotate, but while keeping your head pointing forward, looking forward. And next one is the same the other way. And then, of course, when we are going outside, we can just reach across just like this, looking forward, or reaching across, looking like this, and the same the other way. So you can be just reaching this way and then reaching while rotating the neck, almost like driving, trying to look over the shoulder. You might notice that there is going to be quite a bit of tightness, quite a bit of, let's say, restriction to certain directions, especially for me it's this one across. But again, like, everybody is different. So what I would suggest is from time to time, if people kind of don't mind that you are doing it, and if you're working at home, it's kind of like a no-brainer. You don't need to worry about what other people think. So every so often, once a day, twice a day, three times a day, every hour, every half an hour, doesn't really matter how often you do it. But it's a good idea from this kind of static position, and usually kind of we, at least in my case, this kind of slouch position, just to get a little bit more upright, just to move the back, kind of do those few waves kind of up and down, staying somewhere in the middle, and then just introducing those few reaches, and then again just across, or keeping the head straight. The next option would be you would be rotating to the side, but you would be almost like rotating up or rotating down. It's just going to bring a little bit of extra complexity. And the next one is same over here. You're going to reach across, and you're going to reach across down. You should feel quite nice stretch kind of around the rib cage, around your back. So those movements are going to pretty much get a little bit of that flexion of that movement up and down, and a little bit of rotation pretty much through your whole back. Do it gently, so if you feel kind of tightness, don't just try to blast through it. Just kind of be aware of where it is, and maybe just by repetition that sensitivity to that movement is going to decrease. This up and down and rotation is going to mobilize everything from your hips pretty much to the mid of your neck. The last one, which I love to do, and it's kind of one of my favorites, especially when I feel that tension kind of on the very top of the head, and maybe even it can cause a little bit of like tension headaches kind of all around this area and kind of in behind the head, is a one where I just put my hand just behind the neck, behind the head, just like this. And I'm just going to put my thumb and the index finger on the top of the cheeks, and I'm going to pull with this hand up, and this one push it like this, and I'm just almost like going to tuck the chin. So looking up, looking down, looking up, breathing out, looking down. up and down. You should feel like nice, gentle stretch on the very back of your neck. You shouldn't be forcing it. Those hands are pretty much just guiding the movement. Later on, when you get used to the motion, it's going to be very simple to basically get from this position when, let's say, the screen is over there, or even a little bit higher when you are in this position, as you get a little bit slouch into getting upright and kind of doing just a few of those motions. When you're going to introduce the little bit of this is extension, this is flexion of that very top of the neck. It can oftentimes like 5 to 10 repetitions, and it can be as subtle as this. And you can just keep working. So again, it doesn't require any break from the work, and it can introduce the little bit of extra motion, which can prolong, or it can make your work on or staying in that sitting position a little bit more comfortable. So again, something which is very nice. So this was just very simple mobilization for the back and for the top of the neck. Next we're going to cover maybe the shoulders and elbows when people are suffering a little bit from that repetitive straight injury, like that tennis elbow, although I guess it's not very tennis when we are working just in the office. But that's the topic for the next video.